Now, if you look at history, I consider myself an educated guy. If someone had said to me a few years ago, Dinesh, how many people were killed in the Salem witch trials? I would say, you know, I'm not sure, but, you know, I read Arthur Miller's The Crucible in college, and it's a big spot on American history. I don't know, hundreds, maybe thousands. Well, how many people were killed in the Inquisition? Well, that was kind of a biggie. The Spanish Inquisition, which was the most notorious, probably killed, I don't know, hundreds of thousands, millions. The truth of it is that if you look at history, and there's now a wide and reliable scholarship on all this, I would recommend Henry Kamen's book on the Inquisition. He's considered the greatest living authority on the subject. He points out that the Spanish Inquisition, over a period of 350 years, killed approximately 2,000 people. I'm not exactly a math major, but by my count, that's about 5 guys a year. Now, that's about as many as Pol Pot killed on a good afternoon. My point is, here you have the Inquisition. Well, what about the Salem witch trials? All you have to do is go to Salem. The witches are really thriving. Most of them are now tourist guides. And if you pick up one of their brochures, you'll see right away the number of people killed in the Salem witch trials was in fact precisely 18. Now, that's 18 too many, or 2018 too many, but look, let's keep a little sense of proportion or balance. While the atheists are crying crocodile tears over the crimes of Christianity that occurred 200, 500, or in the case of the Crusades, 1,000 years ago, crimes that, by the way, are unrepeatable today. We're not exactly going to have the Salem witch trials here in Pasadena next week. Meanwhile, the atheists completely ignore and duck and try to get out from under the crimes of atheist regimes, which are not ancient. In fact, they have occurred within living memory in the last century. I'm not just talking about Stalin in Russia or Mao in China or the Nazi regime. True, if you bring those three together, those three regimes in the space of a mere 5 decades killed no fewer than 100 million people. In other words, the regimes of atheism have produced a virtual mountain of bodies and an ocean of blood. We're not even talking about Pol Pot's 2 million, or Ceausescu, Kim Jong-il, Fidel Castro, Enver Hoxha, the list goes on. Now, Richard Dawkins in The God Delusion makes an extremely important qualification. He says, well, yes, it is true, but you have to notice that the Christians killed in the name of Christianity. You may have had tyrants who were atheists, but they really didn't kill in the name of atheism. Now, Dawkins is actually an accomplished biologist, but I think that there are some dangers to letting a biologist leave the lab. And why? Because here is a guy who's straying out of his field, reveals a complete ignorance of history. All you have to do is read the Communist Manifesto. All you have to know is a little bit about these different regimes to see right away that this wasn't a matter of having a dictator who happened to be atheist. The whole idea in Marx is that religion is the opium of the people. The whole idea is to create a new society, a new man, and a new utopia, liberated from the shackles of traditional religion and traditional morality. So here's my bottom line, and that is, if you think the Bin Ladens of the world are bad, Bin Laden in his wildest imagination could not even begin to match the crimes of atheism that have occurred within our lifetime. It is atheism, not religion, that is responsible for the mass murders of history. Now, we'll see for Michael Shermer some dodging on this issue, so I just want to preempt this as I conclude by reading you a line from Daniel Dennett in his book, Breaking the Spell. He says, it is true that the religious fanatics are rarely inspired or guided by the deepest and best tenets of those religions. Then he says this, so what? Al-Qaeda and Hamas, terrorism is still Islam's responsibility, and abortion clinic bombing is still Christianity's responsibility. To which I say, amen. In other words, if crimes are committed in the name of an ideology, the people who share that ideology must accept some responsibility for them. But here's my point. Let's be a little even-handed about that. If that is true of religion, it is also true of atheism. The atheists don't get to dodge and say, well, really, but we wouldn't do that. We're such nice people. The atheists don't get to blame the Christians for Torquemada and then get out of the blame for, say, Stalin. We have to use a single standard in this argument. So I think at the end of the day, we will find that there is good and there is evil. It is, of course, in human nature. We're going to see it everywhere. But if you toll up a little bit of a balance sheet, I think you see that our civilization, including the values that those of you who are secular cherish, wouldn't be there if it wasn't for Christianity. In this sense, I think you can say, even if reluctantly, even Michael Shermer, thank God for Christianity. Thank you very much.